Wilkinson's, what went wrong, eh? What went wrong? Well, I'm going to tell you. I have no formal business qualifications, but it is an industry that intrigues me immensely. And it's a shop that I still love, but at the moment I'm really frustrated and annoyed with. Okay, let's get to the beginning. Started in 1930 as Wilkinson's Hardware Cash Stores, something like that. And it was really good if you were an amateur decorator, or if you were just redecorating your home and you wanted some reasonably good quality products at a fair price. Yes, it's a cliche, isn't it? What business doesn't say that? But Wilkinson's really was. It was the low end of hardware, really. You know, you're a student or you don't have much money at all. You're probably on the dole or whatever. And you wanted to spruce up where you lived. You've probably got a slum landlord or your mortgage was massively high. You know, we'll talk about let's go back to the 1980s here. And you're thinking, do you know what? This is really depressing. I want to redecorate the house. You'd probably go to Wilkinson's. Now, Wilkinson's was a northern chain, and things just bumbled along like that, I'd say, for a good, 40 years. And then things started to change slightly. Now, let's fast forward to 2006. Do you want to buy a house? Yes. Can you manage to earn this house? Yes. Do you mean, can you afford it, yeah? No. Well, I have a mortgage anyway. What can possibly go wrong? Everyone was doing it in the Western world, and then obviously, doof. 2008 was a time when you'd think that focusing on selling homewares would be a terrible idea. Well, no, because you see, Wilkinson's also had its hardware still. You know, you still had your curtain poles and net curtains and bedspread sets, you know, pillowcase, duvet covers, all that sort of stuff, paints and little chintzy things to decorate your house, lamps, nice things to really spruce up your house for very little money. It had a diverse amount of different product. But the years go on and there's no addition of anything good. And then the big one hit. Doof. This is the time that really hits Wilkinson's. Now, they get into the media for treating the staff poorly during the pandemic. For some reason, they were listed as one of the shops that could stay open during the pandemic, and I've already forgotten what they used to call them shops. Was it essentials shops? You know, whatever it was, Wilkinson's was allowed to stay open. But by this time, 5 years previously, the competition had eaten Wilko's dinner. It really had. Poundland was everywhere. Even though Poundland had gone bust, it had come back as One Below. And then it was B&M, Home Bargains. There's loads of different retailers that are doing exactly the same thing but better than Wilkinson's. It's almost as if the granddaughters did the one idea and that was it. Oh, sorry, they changed the name from Wilkinson's to Wilko in about, I think it was 2015, 2014, whatever. It doesn't matter because we have to live in the present, don't we? And if you've got a shop that's got absolutely atrocious stock availability and you've annoyed all your staff so they've probably left, what have you got? A failing company. Whose fault is it? Well, everybody else's, of course, because companies never take blame themselves, do they? Oh, it's the downturn. People are shopping in different places. Oh, it was the market crash. It was the credit crunch. It was the pandemic. Oh, people aren't shopping the way they used to. Well, yes, they are. I do remember using Wilkinson's website. I think this was about 2012, and it was atrocious. You put a keyword in, say if you wanted some blue paint. Well, Wilkinson's do actually sell really good paint, but why are you bringing up the toys that actually contain blue paint? Why are you bringing up every single little thing like a really old school Yahoo search from circa 2001? It was pathetic. I think they've made some slight modifications to the website now, but it's irrelevant now. It was too late. Anyway, that's the internet side of the business. Corinne and Lisa opened up a lot of new stores. The store that I've used in this picture is the one in Hammersmith, which is a rubbish Wilkinson's. Do you know what? The staff were lovely, the ones that are left. The one that is left. There was one member of staff in when I took these pictures. I felt easily just able just to go around and do whatever I wanted. Because there was nothing even to nick for a shoplifter. If a shoplifter went in there, they'd be very disappointed. The shelves are so empty. Is it the manager's fault of the store? Well, no, because there's probably no manager there. Or they're probably so disenchanted with the rest of the staff after being treated so badly during the pandemic. And they've probably left for a better job at Aldi or Lidl that are offering way more money to do the same job. You see, this is the problem Wilkinson's got. It's a multifaceted disaster. They've let the company just sail on and on and on. The iceberg is clear to see. This is not a Titanic situation. They've just hit on into the iceberg. They've annoyed all the people involved in the company. They're now contemplating having a CVA. I do not know what a CVA equivalent is in the US, but what a CVA is as close to administration as you get, because the people in charge of the company still are in charge, but they go to all the creditors and say, look, we don't have the money to pay you. We need to renegotiate how you're going to get paid. You need to agree to this. If you do not agree, we'll have to go into either administration, where a separate company takes over everything and you'll probably get very little, or we'll go into liquidation and you'll probably get even less than little. Obviously nothing. Wilkinson's, I do love Wilkinson's, I really do, and it's really disappointing it's ended in this situation, because it's got so many possibilities, but it's really as if the current people in charge and the previous, the granddaughters, just seems to have creamed off the top and allowed people's jobs to suffer. And that's what bugs me as well, is these are people's lives and they've made their millions and they've cleared off, and now they're just leaving this desolate company with no stock to sell, no staff to sell it. And before I finish, the shameful way they did the self-scan tills in Wilkinson's, they just used the normal staff tills because there's no staff to man them anymore and just turned them round with very basic upgrades and changes to the point of sale system software. It's pathetic. There's no reason to shop in there anymore because there's so little stock. The quality of stuff was good. Then they stopped selling toys, so parents are going to stop shopping there. They used to be quite good for stationery back in the day. There's no stationery on the shelves. Everything that Wilkinson sells is nearly out of stock. If I was a manager at that store, and if it was just a short-term problem, I'd take the shelves down and front fill enough so that it didn't look stupid, but at least make the shop look fuller. And it's not just this little Hammersmith shop. The massive shops in Fulham, Hull and Watford all look like this. It is an absolute avoidable mess. They've still got a chance to sort it out, but they've already sold lots of stuff and took loans from Hilco. And get this, they took a loan from Hilco for the exact same money that they lost. So they've loaned money to throw after bad money. They've leased and they've sold and leased back the distribution. Now that's real scorched earth. You don't come back from that. Do I predict that Wilkinson's will be in administration? Yes. I really don't think it's going to survive after. I don't think there's going to be a Wilkinson's in 2025 at all. And I don't think people are going to miss it, because it's already at that stage where people are avoiding going in because they know whatever they want is out of stock. Anyway, what's your thoughts? Let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for listening. Bye.